Hi guys, my name is Juan A. Poblador. Welcome to this Jurassic-Dreams.com video. I have been wanting a long time to prepare this piece, so it's a pleasure for me to share it with you. This is a long bone which lacks its proximal and distal epiphyses. Therefore, a proper identification is complicated. However, the most interesting detail of this piece is the association of three shark vertebrae in anatomical connection that lean on the bone. My goal today is to clean this piece to discover the morphology of these vertebrae. The job seems easy. The sediment covering the fossil is made of medium-sized sandstone. I will try several methods to see which one is the most appropriate to remove it. This fossil was found in the Upper Cretaceous Cenomanian stage of the Ifezouane formation in the south of Morocco. It's approximately 96 million years old. Now let's get to work. The first thing I'm doing is removing the most superficial layer of sandstone. At many points, it has mineralized, forming crusts of iron oxide with a typical reddish color. In these North African Cretaceous sites, it's relatively common to find remains of large fish and freshwater sharks, but finding articulated remains is extremely rare. The three vertebrae I'm cleaning now are slightly disarticulated, but they retain part of their natural connection. Apart from cleaning the three vertebrae, I'll also try to remove all the superficial sediment attached to the long bone, so I might find out what type of bone it is and maybe what animal it belonged to. But the texture of this bone is very delicate and any tool is too aggressive. I can only afford performing a superficial sweep. Now, this is the most critical part. With great care, I begin to remove the mineralized layer. When we are preparing a fossil, it's very important to know the morphology of the different types of bones so that when you are cleaning, you know how far you can go without damaging the bone. In this case, the round shark vertebrae and its concavity tell me that they have approximately 0.39 inches of sediment to remove. One of the most delicate sectors are the vertebrae edges. These zones can be easily fractured under the pressure applied by the tool. Once I have removed the mineralized surface layer, I can see that the rest of the sediment is more clayey and, fortunately, easier to work with. After a while, I begin to observe the surface of the shark vertebrae. You can observe the characteristic concentric growth lines. I'm really excited because this fossil is turning out to be prettier than I thought. I'm finishing by tweaking some small details. Another day I will continue with the stabilization of the fossil. The long bone seems to have a morphology similar to that of the neural spine of some type of dinosaur, but for the moment I can't say for sure. That's all for today, thanks for watching, and don't forget to visit Jurassic-Dreams.com for an excellent selection of authentic fossil specimens.